Within this video, we are going to say about the Ajax. How to use Ajax with PHP. Before that, we should know what is Ajax. Ajax is the acronym for Ajax is Asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So actually, it is an interrelated technology which comprises of JavaScript, DOM, that is document object model, XML, HTML, CSS, etc. It's a combination of all these things. It allows the data to be sent to the server asynchronously and received in the client side asynchronously. So what do you mean by asynchronous? We'll see in short. Ajax allows you to send only important information to the server, not the entire page. So when the user is, for example, let us take any user interface. If you go inside a web page, it asks for some information, then some CAPTCHA, something like that. All the informations are entered, but while entering that some information, that CAPTCHA, it asks to enter the CAPTCHA again. So only that particular portion will be loaded, not the whole page. All the other informations already which are there, it will not be reloaded again. If it is loaded, if those text boxes and list boxes will be loaded, the user has to enter it again. Instead, only the particular text box where you have to enter the CAPTCHA, only that will be made to load it again. So it allows the user to enter only that portion so that it is easy for them. No need to enter all the informations again. So only the information which are necessary, that only will be rendered again from the server. So only valuable data from the client side is routed to the server side. It makes the applications interactive and faster. So where are all it is used? It is used in Gmail, Facebook, Twitter, Google Map, and YouTube. We'll see where it is exactly used. Okay. I'll show you that Google Map, how it is used. We'll see where it is used. I'll show you this example from the tutorial point so that it will be clear to you. See here, user can drag an entire map by using the mouse rather than clicking on a button. Yes, we can drag. See like this. You can drag and you can see. Then, yes, you can drag like this. And you can click the particular thing and you can go deep inside so that the map expands and even in small things you can see them. So this is an example. And then Google suggest. We'll see what is the Google suggest. Suppose I print data, then it will give automatically data science, data entry job, data mining. So we can select it, auto suggest. So if I press data mining and I can give like this. When I give and, then it gives its own suggestions. So among this, I can decide or I can type that. So this is what it gives automatic suggestions. So this is for one of the application of Ajax. and Gmail, Google Maps, etc. Now, I'll show you more clearly. As I said now, only the particular information is transferred to the server. Not the whole page is not refreshed. Now, see, this is an example. I'll show you that. So then I'll explain it. I am just giving the value. See, 5 × 4. Now, with AJAX, what happens? So this is a standard where the whole page is refreshed. Now I am giving an example in AJAX. Now see what happens. See here, it is not, the whole page is not refreshed. Only this particular portion this portion alone is executed. Whereas, see again, I am telling you 5 and 8. Now I give some other value. Let us see. When I give standard, see, the whole page is loaded again. Now, whereas an AJAX, now I give some value. This is with AJAX. This portion is with AJAX. See here itself, the whole page is not refreshed. It is not going to the first one. So the whole page is not loaded again. This is more useful when more information you are receiving from the client side. So that only the particular portion can be, if any mistake is there, only that particular portions can be sent to the server side and can be received from the server. So now if you see the where it is used, mainly AJAX is used to perform a callback. So what do you mean by a callback? It's a function making a quick round trip to and from the server. Just now what we have done, we have entered 2 values in the text box and we press the button. Immediately the data is sent to the server and the calculation is done through a function which is present in the server or from the server script. Let us take it as a PHP script or something else. And then the data is retrieved and it is placed on the text box. The whole web page is not refreshed. Okay, not, it is not loaded. When I say refresh, the whole page is loaded again. So whatever the text material, whatever the video, everything will be loaded again. So more time it takes. So that can be avoided by using this callback, making a quick round trip to and from the server to retrieve and or save data without posting the entire page back to the page back to the server. Just now what the example I have shown you. By not performing a full post back and sending all form data to the server, network utilization is minimized and quicker operations occur. In sites and locations with restricted bandwidth, this can greatly improve network performance. There are too many web applications running on the web that are using the AJAX technology like Gmail, just now what we have seen. Another example would be to change the values in a drop-down list box. This we should have seen often. Say first it will select a country. Once the country is selected, then it will show only the, in the list box, only the states within that country. Then once the state is selected, it will give only the district within that thing. So like that, dynamically it loads respective information only. So it example be to change the values in your drop-down list box based on other inputs, such as state and college list boxes. When the user selects a state, the college list box will repopulate with only colleges and universities in that college, sorry, in that state. Next, we'll see asynchronous and synchronous. The name itself, AJAX, is asynchronous. The first in AJAX, the A is meant for asynchronous. Asynchronous means it is not that when the client sends the data, whenever the server is free or whenever the server processes the data, it will be sent to the user. It is not that the client has to wait till the data comes. Whereas in synchronous, the client waits for the information to be transferred from the server. Then only it will do other work, okay, other process. So which means if the data is get only the next information it can process. So that is called synchronous. It's a classic web application model. So we'll see that what a synchronous request blocks the client. So he cannot do the anything else. The browser itself will be blocked till the data is received from the server. So blocks the client until operation completes. That is, browser is not unresponsive. In such case, JavaScript engine of the browser is blocked. So for example, this is a server and this is a client. When he clicks, the form data or whatever data he has given in the form, that will be sent to the server. Till the server is giving the result, it will keep on refreshing. No, nothing happens in the browser. It seems that it is blocked. Okay, the user cannot do anything. And he has to wait till all the data is received from the server side. As you can see in the above image, full page is refreshed at request time. So each time the refresh, the whole page is refreshed and user is blocked until the request is completed. Whereas in asynchronous, requests don't block the client. Even if the, when the information is coming from the server, as it comes, it will be loaded into the web page. So it does not wait for the whole page to be loaded. So browser is responsive. At that time, the browser is also responding. The user can do some other operations also. In such case, JavaScript engine of the browser is not blocked. So this Ajax engine takes care of that. As you can see in this picture, full page is not refreshed. So he sends it through browser user interface. He sends the data, which will be received by the server. The server process what has to be sent back to the client. So by the time user is working on some other thing on the browser, then once the data it completes the process, it will send to the browser, which will be received by the browser side. So Ajax is not a technology, but a group of interrelated technologies. This is nothing but HTML, XHTML, and CSS. Whereas these are all meant for style and getting the information for creating the UI, that is user interface. So these are used for displaying the content and style. It is mainly used for presentation. DOM, it is used for dynamic display and interaction with data. And XML or JSON, it is mainly used for carrying data to and from the server. So JSON is nothing but JavaScript object notation. It's like an XML, but short and faster than the XML. And XML HTTP request, it is an object which is mainly meant for asynchronous communication between the client and the server. And JavaScript, it is used to bring all the above technologies together. So with all these things only, the Ajax works. So how Ajax works? Ajax communicates with the server using this HTML, XML HTTP request. It creates an object. So let us say this is from the browser side, that is from client, and this is from the server side. The client first, he through the browser, he enters the data. Then the JavaScript present on the HTML will be called, and it will create a XML HTTP request. And then the data will be, that object will be created, and it will be sent as a HTTP request. In web server, it received that. Then here we have the PHP or servlet, that is a server side scripts, which will process that request. It accesses its data store and then return the data, which in turn will be again processed by this PHP or server side and servlet, and then it will be sent through an XML. And then it will be received by this callback function, which in turn will be sent to the user again in the browser through HTML and CSS. So these are all the activities which is taking place at the backend. User sends a request from just now, whatever I have said is written here. So XML HTTP request object. An object of XML HTTP request is used for asynchronous communication between client and server. That we'll see in the next video.